more sights of the island. On the way, we stopped for a chat with a friendly English policeman. He gave us the same warm reception we received everywhere. Then we went on to Leamington Cave. That's a deep cavern typical of the ones that honeycombed the island. And I want to tell you, our arrival created quite a commotion. Never had Bermuda seen such a caravan of cars and carriages. Why, it was like a royal procession. Yes, Bermuda is an isle of wonders. Caves and natural sea wells, like the Devil's Hole, were a brand new thrill to all of us. This is a natural pool stocked with deep sea fish. Standing on the bridge, we tied a piece of bait to a line and enjoyed a bloodless, hookless fishing. Why, one of the fellas even hooked a turtle. You should have seen it. Came right up out of the water. Look at that splash. We had all the fun of playing the big ones right there on dry land. Then a quick visit to the Elbow Beach Club, Bermuda's most exclusive hotel. Our queen was getting impatient. She began to call us back. But there was still time for another Bermuda custom, bargain hunting. Some of our best huntsmen were Mr. and Mrs. Tom Bell and Bert Fredericks from Los Angeles, real bargaining artists. And every bit as clever were dealers Carol Brown and Joe Caprino and other shipmates. By golly, if Bermuda were any smaller, they'd have bought it too. We returned to the Queen like pirates laden with booty, to find ourselves welcomed by the Dixieland of Peanuts Hunko and his boys. You know, this was typical of the party atmosphere that brightened the whole trip. Sylvania made sure that the accent was on fun and in large doses. So long, Bermuda. We'd miss you. But more fun was calling us to the south. So with few regrets, the Queen pointed her bow into the Gulf Stream and eased toward Nassau. That night, we threw gloom and dignity overboard and tossed caution to the wind, turning the ship into one grand ruffles room. Red or blue beanies made us members of a team, and the games were on. It was, let's go blue, or let's go red, as we huffed and puffed to get our tea into a straw. Get to know a gal fast in the Pass the Lifesaver game. Hey, this is like being in the rush. She may know how to keep house, but can she sew? We found out. We had some pretty big guys with us, but they made beautiful babies. We didn't have to change them either. Just handed them a bottle and let them chug a lug. Wonder what's in that bottle. There were medals for the winners and losers alike. And a kiss from our hostess, Nellie McGuire. Then our dancers took over and carried the party into the small hours of the morning. ¶¶